Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the opening ceremony for NYIT's MBA Executive Cohort of Fall 2015. My name is Cui Dan. I'm very excited to be here to be today's hostess because I was graduated from this school. I was graduated in 2008 in MBA program. 7 years passed, a lot of things changed. The new auditorium, a new provost, and a lot of new face. However, one thing remains unchanged. That is Dr. Sky Liu. He is my teacher and my old friend. He still serves as a faculty in this institution, but he looks wiser and younger. Now, let's welcome Dr. Liu for his opening remarks. Please.
Thank you, Dan. Cui Dan, and welcome. Thank you for attending this event. And first, let me show you a picture. This is the first cohort of MBA executive with eight students, we introduced the program in collaboration with Tsinghua University. My cellular phone, the cellular phone of that time, because I did not foresee what we will have today, the audience and the view. Could go, yeah, then next. That is what we have today. And this summer, we made a decision. We want to make a video to tell some stories about our program. And we have a small budget, but big passion, and an excellent team with 2.5 months effort. That is what we have.
Is the Universal Center for Global Learning and a driving force for cross-border transfer of education.
We've been running programs in China since 1997, the very first wave of universities.
教授，我们知道您取得了很多的成就，那么在众多的成就当中，最让您感到骄傲的是什么成就？回顾往事，我觉得对我个人来说最有意义的，就是我与我的母校江西财经大学合作举办的中美MBA项目，因为这个项目不仅为中国培养了许多高级管理人才，而且也改变了我所在的 NYT 纽约理工大学，我们中国的MBA 项目是 NYT 的第一个国际项目。今天我们看 NYT 已经是一个 multinational university， 也就是说跨国大学。但是 NYT 的国际化是从中国开始的，是从我们江西开始的。我个人很渺小，但是我能够对美国一所主要大学 的发展方向产生影响，我终身感到自豪。The
NYIT Zufi Joint MBA Program is among the first batch of foreign programs approved for operations by China's Ministry of Education in 1997. It produced its first cohort of graduates in December 1999. The second cohort graduated in 2002. Here's the opening of the sixth cohort and the ceremony to award an honorary degree. Chairman Wu of Zufi receives the honorary doctorate degree. The eighth cohort and NYIT's Alumni Association in China in 2009.
in appreciation and recognition of your commitment to global peace and understanding and your efforts to help advance NYT's educational vision in China. Thank you so much.
Bill Gates of Microsoft was also the recipient of the NYIT President's Award. Finally, we come to the opening for the 15th cohort. We are pleased to be growing together with China, and we are proud of our small contribution to China's success. In addition, China's Ministry of Education has approved NYIT's joint college with CUC, as well as its cooperative programs with MUPT and SDIBT. NYIT introduced the first MBA executive program in 2009. This partnership was extended to Renmin University of China. Next, we teamed up with Xiamen University. And then Jinan University in Guangzhou. Then followed cooperation with another elite institution in higher education, the China University of Mining and Technology.
Then, what do we try to do? First, let's listen to what my colleague from MIT think.
He's an MIT professor who believes the future of education is on the internet. Professor Agarwal, thanks so much for coming on.
Oh, my now, pleasure.
You're a professor of electrical engineering and computer science at MIT.
That's
you're
right.
Also the president of edX. How many people are online in the edX right now?
We have over a million students from every single country in the world
right
taking
now,
their
a
online
million
courses.
Students right
over
now
a million online? Students right now from every single country in the world.
How do you ask questions?
So the whole thing is done online. A millennial generation is so much more comfortable doing everything online. We have discussion forums with Ask Questions online. And the amazing thing is that in addition to professors and teaching assistants answering questions, much more than that, there's peer learning going on where the students are answering each other's questions and they're saying that they're learning by teaching. It's absolutely amazing.
So they're teaching each other?
Yes.
Well, eventually they won't need us.
Will colleges be disappearing? Maybe, if a college provides only academic learning, because with the power of internet, we only need one super university with a master teacher in each field to provide programs to students worldwide. But education also includes experiential learning, which cannot be centralized, nor be delivered virtually. Based on such a belief, we have transformed the program. Now, let's see.
We enjoy finishing the program at Stanford. The classroom is located in the engineering building. Professor Tom teaches the behavioral aspects of marketing. These two are the smartest girls in my class. They must have passed this course. You know what? Jean got an A in this course. After professors Eugene and John finished their course on startups in Silicon Valley. This study trip has really made you two look more sophisticated. We also visited some major American companies. Bella, this model is almost as beautiful as you. The crab in San Francisco is so delicious. We are here, training rigorously at West Point to build up strength, will, and team spirit. Here we are learning the application of West Point leadership and business management. General Eisenhower was a West Point cadet, and he became the 34th President of the United States. General Patton was not great at West Point, but he became a hero in World War II. Lieutenant Colonel Hank is both loved and hated, and you would know why if you attended his training session. Our mission is to defeat the enemy on top of the hill.
Be careful!
Please help. This is the topic of today's lecture by Colonel John Willis. Professor Skalm is one of the most popular teachers at West Point. Let's enjoy the Army food. We have completed a certificate program at New York University, and here is that certificate. NYIT is not Ivy League. It's better by bringing together the bests. This is the John Harvard statue, and on the night before exams, students come to touch his feet for good luck. This is just before going to class. Professor Siegel from Harvard Business School lectures on global strategy. They are all so quiet and attentive. A group picture after class. Professor White is not really that small. It just seems so because she is next to Wang Yang, who used to team up with Yao Ming. Our team won. Boston has a beautiful autumn. We are walking toward a bright future. This is what we've learned. Stand tall and see far. Only by being with the best can you open your eyes, learn quickly, and excel.
As part of its mission, NYIT graduates students that are ready to take on unique professions and be able to participate in experiential learning that enables them to be ready and prepared for professions not only regionally but globally.
A business person should be a good golfer for business relations. So, we came here to play golf. A presentation on golf and business success. We have pros teaching us how to play golf. And here is the demonstration. Mr. Daniel Yu is Chief Operating Officer of Matrix, a world leader in producing premium golf clubs. We are on our way to the course. Everyone had a good time. Oops, I missed this one, but I have picked up on other good pointers for life here. We went to the Federal Reserve Bank, America's central bank, whose gold vault stores the largest quantity of gold known in the world. After the presentation, we had first-hand knowledge about the central bank's functions. Questions and answers. Then we went down, deep into the gold vault beneath the bank building. The security is so incredible. Bank robbery? That only happens in movies. We see gold. A lot of gold, in amounts we have never seen before. After this visit, we all feel a little bit richer. Wine is part of American business culture, so we need to learn about it. A study trip to Brotherhood Winery teaches us the essentials. And a course taught by Professor Robert reveals the secret of wine. This is the oldest wine cellar on the East Coast. This wine is so delicious, and so are our lives. Let me try it too. We are the world. The winery trip ends up with Japanese food, plus sake. These are the five beauties from the fifth cohort of MBA executives, and they sort of remind me of Princess Diana.
I wish I could have met her. However, her butler, Paul Barreau, is coming here, and at least I could have a chat with him, and of course, a picture, because I'm also a world-class celebrity.
We all want to have a picture.
Welcome to all our students. I think you'll find your experiences here of high quality. You get a lot of value out of your academic program and your co-curricular experiences. As you know, our programs are fully accredited by the Association for Advanced Collegiate Schools of Business. Again, I'm happy to have you here, and feel free to call upon me for help at any time. Have a wonderful day.
Hi everyone, my name is Dan. Today I come here to find out what do students think about this program? Why did you choose to study in NYIT?
Because NYIT is in New York, and kept your word word.
Definitely, we have a lot of fun.
Do you like this program?
Yeah, of course, and I've never been so happy to study here.
Hi, I'm Xian Jing, an NYIT alumna. My initial involvement with NYIT's activities was by pure chance. It was one day in April of 2009, I got a call from Professor Scott Liu, asking me to help organize NYIT's 10-year anniversary in Nanchang. At that time, I was very sick, lying in bed with a bad flu and fever. However, I felt it was my call, and I flew to Nanchang by the next flight. I started to work immediately upon arrival. Fortunately, the video script of this event won a silver medal in a contest for American college students. Afterwards, I got more and more involved with NYIT in China, from development of partner institutions, recruitment, supports to national conferences and invitation for VIP speakers, media promotion, to the most recent setup of NYIT's China office in Shanghai. I would like to thank President Giuliano, Provost Dramat, Dean Jess, and particularly my professor, Scott Liu, and Vicky. It is all because of them I have been devoted to the NYIT cause. In addition, I'm appreciating Jackie Lin, my MBA classmate and also an NYIT alumnus. To tell the truth, the NYIT business is only my sideline. Then, what is my core? After graduating from MBA, I moved to Beijing, and my last job was working for a hotel chain as executive vice president. I was moving up quickly. In 2008, I was recognized as one of top 10 professional managers in China's hotel industry, and that rank was largely based on salaries. That year, and at that time, I decided to leave the company to have my own startup. I'm lucky, because I started business armed with the MBA learning. The hotel business is highly competitive, with competitiveness based on scale. Therefore, I must have a niche, boutique hotels in the resort area. In 2008, I launched my first hotel in Zhitang Ancient Town in Zhejiang, China. At that time, tourism was not well developed there, and the average per night rate for a hotel was 40 yuan. But my hotel, Fei Gan Song, started with 580 yuan and up. The local folks talked about this as a joke, and my friend Jack even offered his living room as my shelter in case my business failed. To their surprise, only in the second month, my hotel turned to be profitable. Afterwards, my business started to take off. Today, I have my own hotel investment and management company, own three brands, receive many awards in the hotel industry, and my business is frequently covered by media. The most recently opened hotel is located in Xinjiang Ancient Town, near Shanghai Disney Resort, and rate is 2,580 yuan per night. From 580 yuan to 2,580 yuan, the price change has symbolized the transformation of my business. Based on my experiences, I have seen the power of knowledge. I hope our alumni be more actively involved in NYIT, and I hope NYIT be chosen by more people as a platform to build up personal successes.
Let me put it in this way. Perhaps because I'm not a person who is easily getting content, or because I've been in the same business for too long, and thus desire a change. I've been a lawyer for over 10 years with my own law firm. As some people see it, I am well off and should be ready for retirement and in no need to work hard anymore. I want to study and thus find NYIT to pursue business education. This school provides programs customized to our needs, and such we have visited Harvard, Stanford, West Point, Yale, San Francisco, Orlando, Miami, and so on. As we were in New York, we definitely should see Wall Street and Federal Reserve. All these experiences have opened our eyes and broadened our horizons. Upon my graduation, I just turned 40 and have fulfilled my dream to enter a new industry, establish a new business, and live in a new city. Today, I am with my partners to build an online superstore, gatewang.com. Finally, I would like to share with you a few words, joining together. And let's all come to join the big NYIT family.
Hi everyone, I'm Yu Chen, a graduate of NYIT's MBA Executives in 2014. I am from Jiangsu Rinsen Steel Group and CEO and a co-founder of the company. Today, our company has $10 billion in total assets, a plant occupying 800 acres of land, and with the capacity to produce 6 million tons of steel and makes over $20 billion in sales. We are playing a positive role promoting the economic growth of Northern Jiangsu. The study at NYIT has left me with wonderful memories, and I have learned a great amount from the knowledgeable Dr. Liu and other faculty. With more appreciation of the merits of Western culture, we have integrated Chinese and Western cultures into the strategic management, and our business has benefited from it greatly. In today's world, with rapid changes driven by globalization, high tech, and the internet, we need to study continuously and be open-minded to keep pace with the time. I believe that the NYIT experience shall bring you all a bright tomorrow. I believe that as long as there is a healthy and positive outlook on life, striving to the pursuit of goals and dedication to society, life will be great. Last but not least, I wish everyone success in work and be healthy.
We have many more touching stories, but I have to control the time. This summer, when we decide to make a video, so I send a request to many of graduates from our program, asking for their stories about life, job, and NYT experience. It turned out I received so many video scripts. When I read it, I was in tears because I know every one of them. Then I was even heartbroken because to create this video, I have to cut off many, many of wonderful stories to have what we have today. I consider myself very lucky because I can directly see the outcome of my efforts. That is not so for many other jobs. So that's one reason I have invited many guests. They are all stakers of NYIT here. And I want to tell them we are all a part of big job to make NYIT great, to have impact on the students. Here I want to say I'm grateful to you from the bottom of my heart for all of your support and help. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Liu. Thank you very much for your great contribution to NYIT's globalization. Thank you very much. Next, let's invite Dr. Rimashi Rashi, NYIT's Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, to give us a welcome speech.
Good afternoon, or I should say, ni hao. Boy, after watching this video, I don't know what to say. I'm so impressed. Scott, you have done great. Thank you. I have the fortune of attending either the opening or graduations of MBA programs at JUFI, and it's always a great moment for me. It's a proud moment for NYIT. So I would like, on behalf of President Giuliano and the NYIT family, to welcome the new MBA executive program cohort to New York and to NYIT. You are in the right institutions, and you are going to get the right education to prepare you for a bright future. And what a better evidence than what you saw in these videos. And I also want to personally recognize all of the effort that not only Professor Liu has done, but one of our special alumni of this program, and that's Gene. And so Gene, we are thankful for all of your effort and contribution. We have another great example of the graduates of this program, and that is Mr. Wu Shandong, that is gonna talk to us. I have had the pleasure of meeting with him now twice over the last couple of months, and I'm so impressed with looking at an individual and NYIT alumni and what he has been able to achieve. And I have to say, given how young he is, I'm so impressed. So, Mr. Shandong, we are delighted to have you as an alumni of NYIT. Now, over the last 3.5 decades, China's economy has transformed, and it has built as a solid manufacturing economy, not only for China, but for the rest of the world. And it also is going through the transition of becoming more of a digital and service economy. And with every transition, there are ups and downs. And as Yao Ming, how many of you know Yao Ming? You know what he says? He says, sports teaches you how to be quick. Injuries teach you how to slow down. NYIT, as a not-for-profit institution, plays an important part in building human capital. As a new MBA cohort, you will be well prepared to meet China's need for leaders who can manage people, synthesize ideas, and grow business enterprises. Xinhua News Agency recently reported that a significant part of China's economic transition involves integration of rural parts of the country into the global economy. Remote towns and villages are crossing boundaries via the internet and other technological advances to connect with the developed economic life of urban China. In short, where Alibaba goes, the economy grows. How many of you know Alibaba? In addition to your business and technology skills that you will gain by studying NYIT Executive MBA, this education will also show you the ability to cross cultural boundaries. A recent survey of 225 Chinese managers working for multinational organizations in China shows that cultural intelligence corresponds with both communication effectiveness and job satisfaction. As part of your NYIT education, you will learn about different cultures, and you will be a great example of crossing the boundaries of cultures. So, in short, I want to welcome you. Good luck with your education. Enjoy your time at NYIT and the greatest city in the world, that is New York.
Now, I would like to invite Dr. Jess Bronico, Dean for School of Management, to make some comments and present awards to recognize some outstanding alumni.
Thank you, Before I begin, I'd like to just recognize and give thanks to Dr. Shureshi, Provost and Vice President of Academic Affairs, without whom this program would not be sustainable and could not be offered. Please join me in thanking him for supporting us. I would also be remiss if I did not extend my warm appreciation and thanks to Dr. Scott Liu. He has been instrumental in developing and growing this program for many years, and we are all here because of Dr. Liu and only because of Dr. Liu. Thank you. Welcome to NYIT, and please accept my thanks at joining our global community and for creating a partnership with us, a partnership that will persist well beyond the walls of this academic institution, well beyond the boundaries of your academic and curriculum experiences, towards an evolving and sustainable lifelong commitment that we make to you, with thanks to you, in supporting your personal and your professional goals, your aspirations, and your lifelong dreams. We promise that to you. While you are here, you will be in a curriculum that is dynamic, is infused with technology, and globalized. You will learn from faculty who are experts in their field, highly credentialed, and who will merge academic theory into practice. You will have numerous cultural experiences and learn from professionals and officers at many fine places, including the United Nations and Wall Street. And please remember that as a part of the NYIT School of Management, you are students of a program that is accredited by the AACSB, and the School of Management and its executive MBA program are among only 5% of schools worldwide that have that credential. And you are a part of our family and our team. And finally, I simply wish to tell you I have an appreciation for you being here. I am here to help. I am but a very small piece of this institution. I am blessed to have so many wonderful students, friends, participants, faculty, and partners who have created a dynamic and continually growing and strengthened community. I am blessed and grateful for that. I am here to help you. Please let me know how I can help you, and thank you for being here. At this time, I would like to welcome one of our faculty members, Dr. Paul Katasevic, to come to the stage to recognize two of our esteemed partners from industry who have worked many years in helping us develop a course called the Broadridge Challenge and continue to contribute to the welfare of our students. Please welcome Dr. Paul Katasevic.
Thanks, Jess, pleasure being here today. And I'm here to honor two of our business partners from Broadridge Challenge. We run a course every year called the Broadridge Challenge, where basically I'm kind of the faculty mentor, and I actually don't have to teach it. These guys do all the hard work for me and do a terrific job. It's a great experience for our students. A lot of students say it's probably the best experience here. They make actually a presentation to the CEO of the company and developing a business plan. So my great honor to present an award to William Jonico and Jelani Arnold.
So on behalf of Billy and I, I'd like to just thank Jess, Paul, and Scott for continuing to give us the opportunity to participate in these classes and to be a part of the EMBA experience. As alumni, we appreciate all the recent successes NYIT has made with the Tempos Initiative, with experiential education, as well as with the AACSB accreditation. So on behalf of Billy and I, we'd like to again just thank all of the School of Management for not only continuing to engage us as stakeholders, but giving us the opportunity and a platform to give back to the NYIT community. So again, thank you.
Representative Dr. Robert Koenig, also Associate Dean for School of Management.
I was worried. I wanted to make sure I wasn't wearing the same suit. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our beautiful auditorium on Broadway as we come to celebrate the opening ceremony of the EMBA executive cohort for the fall 2015. And Dr. Liu, I congratulate you for an outstanding job. And Jenny, God bless you, and thank you for everything. Congratulations. I'd like to welcome all of you today, and thank you for joining us on this very special and exciting day. On behalf of my fellow colleagues and faculty members, it is truly an honor and a privilege to be a part of this very special celebration. I'd like to welcome and thank all the wonderful administrators, Dr. Shureshi, Victoria Pfeiffer, and all others for making today's event possible. You are outstanding leaders of our college, and I feel truly blessed to have the opportunity to work alongside of each and every one of you. But most importantly, I'd like to welcome you, the EMBA students for the fall 2015, for it is your hard work, your dedication to detail, and the willingness to challenge yourself to learn new thoughts and ideas that has brought you here today. However, it will be your integrity, your character, your honesty, and the respect that you demonstrate with the knowledge that you will have gained here at NYIT that will truly make you the leaders of tomorrow that we all know each and every one of you will become. By having the opportunity now to study here in the United States of America at the New York Institute of Technology, you will be able to enhance your understanding of various cultures, values, and principles, as well as business and social etiquette, styles, and techniques, while engaging and embracing an array of new philosophies and experiences that will surely strengthen your future career and personal endeavors as you go through life's journeys. While attending your studies here at NYIT, we encourage and emphasize each of the students to participate within the School of Management's unique Triple Platforms of Excellence. The Triple Platforms of Excellence provides a distinct competency for students of School of Management that speak to the competitive advantage that they bring into the marketplace upon their graduation. We have three main platforms. One is experiential learning. This complements in-class instruction in diverse ways, including academic service learning, study abroad programs, internships, practicum experiences, faculty mentee, undergraduate research, and work experience with business and industry leaders. Secondly, we have our wonderful professional enrichment programs, which offers co-curricular activities during which students meet and network with area specialists, learn from business leaders, become involved in work-related endeavors such as job shadowing, and attending many seminars, workshops, and forums on professional readiness and work current issues. Lastly, the Student Advancement Program, sponsored under the wonderful sponsor, Ms. Deborah Vogel, supports the school's commitment to student engagement activities that engage our students across varied platforms with their peers, faculty, staff, community members, and industry partners. Whether it is by way of clubs, honor societies, industry field trips, or community outreach projects, the program seeks out those activities that bring stakeholder groups together for the purpose of creating a vibrant community with synergies that advance the academic and professional aspects of all participants. The School of Management believes that one of the core values of becoming a participant of the Triple Platforms of Excellence that will not only enhance a student's communication, leadership, and team building skills, but it can provide a foundation of integrity, character, discipline, and respect for all that you do in one's life. We hope within the School of Management to demonstrate ongoing perpetual learning that should be embraced during the student's entire career and lifestyle. Within the School of Management at NYIT, we explain to our students, it is up to you to seek your success in life. Here at NYIT, your faculty, your administrators, your staff, your peers will do all we can to help and support and guide you, but you also need to do your part and get involved. I personally explain to my students, it is up to you to seek your success in life. And Thomas Jefferson said something that I try to instill in every one of my students, and I quote, I am a great believer in luck, and I find the harder I work, the more I have of it, close quote. The Triple Platforms is developed on core principles that will enhance the NYIT School of Management students of today to become our future leaders of tomorrow. Some of these core principles embedded in our program are some, and I'll share some with you. One, become involved in community outreach programs, and we offer many of them here within the college. By partaking in community outreach projects, it builds character, leadership skills, ethics, values, and integrity. Make sure you enjoy the career that you're pursuing. Have a passion and enthusiasm for what you're doing in life, because you'll never really work a day in your life if you could find that true passion. Also, be professional in all that you do. Always work on your soft skills, your manners, thank you, please, may I, whether you're speaking in professional conversations, social etiquette, or emails, everything represents you and who you are as an individual. You're here in the United States now, and we are so thankful to have you here. Make sure you're open-minded, learn about other people's values, ideas, listen to people's thoughts and suggestions, especially if they're successful and they have many years of experience. And also, take responsibility for the things you do in life and be dependable. Believe in yourself, have a quiet confidence, but never boast or display arrogance. And my friends, my EMBA program students, and I see you next week, by the way, set goals for yourself. Where do you want to be in 5 years, 10 years, and 15 years? Where do you want to be, and how are you going to get there? It's nice to have goals, but you need to also think of the strategies and the steps in order to attain those goals. One of the reasons why many people do not always accomplish their goals is that they do not plan on how to achieve their goals. It's not that people plan to fail, it is that they fail to plan. And whatever you do in life, do it the best you can. Don't take any job that it's not too serious. How do you expect to get the higher jobs if you can't do the lower jobs? Myself, many years ago, I used to be a chef, and I did pretty well. But I didn't start off as a chef. I started also as a pot washer, washing dishes as a young kid. But I knew if I wanted to raise and grow up and make my way up the corporate ladder, I had to be the best possible dishwasher I can in order to go to the next level. And by the way, I was a pretty good dishwasher. And on a side note, my wife keeps me in training still. And basically, when you're doing your job, good enough is not good enough. Always strive to surpass all expectations in whatever you do in life, and you must do that on a consistent basis. Perpetual learning. Learning never stops. Knowledge is power. Surround yourself with individuals that you can learn from. Be like a sponge. Absorb all the positive leadership skills and work habits from the better managers you are fortunate to work for. And any of the negative managers or the managers that you see bad habits from, learn something there also. Learn what not to do as a manager in your future career. And also, very importantly, treat those around you with the same respect that you wish to have others display onto you. Make sure that you also have a balanced life. Work is important, but not all work and nothing else is not good either. Have a balanced life, family, friends, career, faith, hobbies, and interests. And learn from your mistakes. When we learn from our mistakes, it enhances our managerial decisions and our styles, and we become stronger as managers and leaders. And improve those around you. All of you will become teachers in your own way. Learn to educate and teach those skills of the people who work for you, because you need to become better as a team. You need to build a team. It cannot just be you if you want to become a leader. And learn to network, to be a part of professional associations or organizations that will help you develop, and we will help you find those appropriate organizations and associations here within the School of Management to help you put on the right career path and make the most out of each and every day. Make the most out of each and every day with the ones you love and care for, your teachers, your faculty, and your loved ones. And I believe it was Abe Lincoln who once said, "It is not the years in your life that matter, but the life in your years." And when your life is complete, did you make a difference? How do you want to be remembered? What was the impact that you had? And remember, what's going to make you a success, my EMBA students, is you. Backed up by an exceptional education, which you will get here at the New York Institute of Technology, with professional skills and presentation and the willingness to always want to learn and appropriate soft skills, you can accomplish anything you want in your life. And lastly, maintain the highest of standards for your life and in who you are. I believe the most important asset our students have is in their name and who they represent. It is in your name, the students, and the way you live your life, as well as the professionalism that our students display, that will become a reflection on their success in life. Never sacrifice the value of your name and all it represents. Be sure to have integrity, honesty, principles, and values in everything that you do. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for letting me join you here today to celebrate Scott Liu and Miss Jenny in welcoming the EMBA Executive Cohort for Fall 2015. Thank you and God bless you. Thank you.
Now let's welcome the students' representative, Mr. Asai.
Hi everyone, Ni Men Hao. Welcome to New York. You are all about to embark on a very, very big journey, as I have these past 4 to 5 years. I am not a management student. I was under the department of Dean Nada Anid in the computer science field. However, I have just graduated and now I am back here for my master's. I have seen the school change over the past 4 years, as I have changed also tremendously. I have studied in China for 6 years. I studied abroad in the Nanjing campus, and it has completely changed my life. I met one of the most influential teachers of my life there. He showed me a lot of great things for management that I think you all need to know. He would set up some dinner dates with a lot of other students, and then he would tell the other students that me and my roommate, who also traveled abroad, had paid for them. And for a long time, we wondered, why did he do that? Well, there's two main important languages that you need to know, and that is food and money. He taught me that even if you don't have a lot of money or you don't have a lot of resources, there's a lot of ways you can be creative to really excel in life. I had done a project here with a few management students, and do you know how they paid me? They gave me hot pot. And it was the best payment ever. I love food. So you don't necessarily need money to connect with other students. You are at NYIT, and your journey over the next year will be very difficult, but there's a lot of ways you can make it easier. And right now, this is the easiest time in your career, because NYIT has a lot of opportunities here for you and a lot of great students that you can connect to. If you want to know about the best local restaurants, or you want to try some Indian food or some really good American food, which will probably be just cheeseburgers, but the only way to really do that is to connect with the students that have been here for a while, right? So the best way to do that is to, like Robert Koenig said, Professor Robert Koenig, he said, to get involved. You are graduate students, and many of the clubs are usually hosted by undergrads, but that doesn't stop you from joining them and getting to know other students here. And I think you shouldn't be too shy about the language barrier, because like I said, there's only two main languages. So I would invite you all to come talk with me anytime, or any of the students here, and just get to know them. There's a big world of opportunity out there for you. And I would like to thank Dr. Scott Leo and all of the faculty and students here for having me to speak to you today.
Thank you, Zach. Now, it's the end of the formal ceremony. Thank you everyone for coming. And we will have 10 minutes break. After that, we'll come back and have a speech by Mr. Wu. It's a very meaningful and useful speech, so don't miss it. Thank you.
接下来我们的演讲是中文，但是我们会有一个翻译。Next speech is by Chinese, but there is a translator. Let's welcome Hui Heng be the translator, and let's welcome Wu Shandong, Mr. Wu. He's the chairman and founder of Dixun Genetic Engineer Company. Let's welcome him.
首先非常感谢刘院长给了我这样的机会。
Thanks for providing with me such a great opportunity. Thanks to Dr. Scott Liu.
更感谢学校给了我这里一个学习的机会。
I'm more even grateful for NYIT to provide me such a learning opportunity.
我本身是学生命科学的，但是到这里学了这个 MBA 以后，对于我来说是人生的一大改变。
My previous major was in life science. I then came to NYIT to receive the MBA program, and it was a great turning point for my life.
大家好，我们公司和属实妇女性疾病的诊断、治疗、预防为主的高科技公司。公司在大家共同的努力下，我们在中国实现了三个第一。在部门领域，我们是第一个获得了国家药监局的批号，填补了中国的部门。第二个第一，在部门领域，我们是第一个获得了教育部科技进步一等奖。第三个第一，在部门领域，我们是第一个获得了国家科技进步二等奖。下面我带大家去看看我们的公司，这是我们公司的办公大楼，这是我们公司的实验室，这是我们做的这个蛋白芯片的平台。过去这个蛋白芯片都被国外所垄断了，经过我们大家共同的努力下，我们将4G 仪器软件为一体的这个平台终于开发了成功。我们不单能做过敏原的蛋白芯片，也为做肿瘤的蛋白芯片、自身免疫的芯片等等奠定了良好的基础。这是我们的分子生物学平台，主要是从事真菌的基因检测项目。下面我们带大家看看，这是我们的园区。这个园区在2011年之前是一个烂尾工程，在我们大家共同的努力下，我们将这个烂尾工程打造成了中国第一个生物医药诊断试剂的 集聚地和海量外发生的这个集聚地，目前已有100多家企业入驻，3个主要的产业和创办人。这是我们正在规划的第二个科技园区，主要集孵化器、加速器、产业园、特种生物园。这是我们办公室，这是我们的办公和实验基地，后面就是我们的产业基地。今天我将重点介绍在纽约理工学习的新的体会，也让我更好地领略了美国的高科技。在学习期间，我们还跟普林斯顿大学、加州大学、麦伦大学、犹他大学合作。在2012-2013年的时间，我们把这几个大学合作的项目引进了这叫做浙江省海内外高层次认知的重点项目，让我们提高了国际视野。在学习期间，2011年9月，经过华人协会的推荐，将我们所做的工作进行了整理。答辩以后，我和方博还分别获得了100家杰出奖。同时，我们还受到了美国加州议员、美国国会议员、经济学家接见。更重要是，让我们更好地领略到了美国的文化，使我们更顺利地能跟比利时进行合作。这是我们收到比利时公司的 The Technology 公司的项目，在2015年6月20至27日，比利时国王访问中国期间，我们受国王和王后的邀请下，我们代表两国签订的合作项目，这是我们双方签约的项目。这是国王，这是比利时王后，这是我们两国之间合作项目的一个合影，就是我在纽约理工学习的新的体会。最后，也祝愿新入学的同学，相信你们在刘院长的培养下会有个更高的提升和更大的收获。谢谢大家。
由于这个来的时候呢，院长说这里主要是我们这个MBA 的学生，所以当时呢这个呢也没做好一个特别充分的准备。那我想呢，今天我想我重点呢就按照这个呢讲以下几个内容啊，我的创业之路。
So today's my lecture title will be my path to entrepreneurship.
从不轻易放弃学习，奋斗是我一生的目标。
Never give up learning. Fighting is the dream of my life.
下面我主要讲这几个内容。第一个，梦想成就未来。
First, by having a dream, we can achieve our future.
我引用了乾隆皇帝的三句话，治国之道。
And here you can see this is a famous quote by one of the emperor from Qing Dynasty.
尽己之力，下君之策。
By using your own power, it is the last strategy to resort to.
尽人之力，忠君之策。
By using other people's power, that is the second strategy.
尽智之力，上君之策。
By using thepower of other intelligence people, that is the best strategy.
谢谢。为什么说梦想成就了未来？在2001年的时候，我原来是在这个大学的实验室工作的。当时我们的这个实验室是有着非常这个优秀的科研成果。
Back in 2001, I was working as a researcher in a lab in a university, and at the time we have achieved great achievements.
我非常梦想想把这些科研成果转化为生产力。
And it was my dream to transfer this intellectual property to the actual production.
但是我的领导，我的一个处长跟我讲了三句很经典的话。
At the time, my boss told me 3 sentences.
第一句话说，小吴，你是我们这里资历最浅的一个人。
First, Shen Dong, you are the youngest staff here.
第一，你不是处长，也不是院长，这些大牌教授是不会听你的建议的。
You are not the head, department head, you are not the chief, so nobody, no, faculty will listen to you.
第二个，你不是学科带头人，这些专家也不会听你的。
You are also not a head of the, research team, that's why they won't listen to you either.
第三个，这些科研成果要转化生产力，你没有资金也是很难完成的。
It is even harder to, achieve your dream by transferring this intellectual property to actual production by not having enough funding.
三句话对于我来说确实非常有道理。
At the time, these all made sense to me.
后来我经过了足足一年多时间的准备。
And I prepared for over a year.
当时我们这个署里的书记是中科院恢复高考以后第一届的研究生。
At the time, my boss was the first, graduate students from Chinese Academy of Science after 1978 when the national exam, to college was back.
也是一个非常著名的科学家。
He was also a very famous scientist.
然后我就想到从这样的一个科学家身边下手。
And I thought I should be starting with this person.
因为老师有一个优点，没有不喜欢努力的学生。
It is common to every professor that they always like students who work very hard.
经过两年的努力，我就从这个领导、这个科学家的身边去开始我的工作。
So I started my work by working with this professor closely for 2 years.
所以从04年的1月18号开始。
And it started January the 8th, 2004.
我不但实现了浙江大学、复旦大学、北京大学的一篇专家的资源。
And at the time I finished a paper in collaboration with Zhejiang University,复旦 University and Beijing University.
同时我还把集合了美国的哈佛大学、加州大学、迈阿密大学、犹他大学。
Also, this project was in collaboration with Harvard University, Miami University, Utah University.
德国帕洛研究所。
And a research institute in German.
荷兰瓦赫林根大学。
The University in Holland.
我把这些大学的这些专家的资源，总共有30多个专家都集聚到我这里。
So at the time, I have collected all resources from these over 30 universities all over the world.
在2008年的时候，把我这个模式就是成为了这个MBA 的一个研究课题和管理的教材，叫《高端人才的管理模式与探讨》写入的。
In 2008, I published a paper, How to Manage the High-Level Intellectuals as a research topic of my MBA thesis.
研究的内容是，人家的管理模式都是管理比你差的人，啊，大学生或者说普通的工人，而你所管理的东西是，都是比你优秀，而且要优秀的很著名的人。
And the content of this paper was, as a fresh graduate or ordinary staff, how to manage some people who are way better than you, for example, researchers, faculty members.
其中一个很典型的例子就是加拿大那个 UBC 大学。
One example is from University of British Columbia in Canada.
一个教授给我非常鼓舞，讲了三句话。第一句话说，跟我谈的说，英雄所见略同。
And a professor from UBC told me three sentences, which I still remember to this day. First, he said, "Great minds think alike."
第二句话说，虽然我的年龄跟他有很大的差距，但是我们的思想没有距离。
And second was, even though there was an age difference between me and him, however, the mind of thinking has no difference.
第三句话说，我现在还不能退休，我要跟你一起共同完成这件事业，我才能退休。
And third is, I cannot retire at this moment because I have to fight with you until we achieve our dreams.
也正因为有这样的一个大胆的想法，后来我的处长说我做了我大家所不敢想的事情，做了大家所不能做的事情。我当时的起家就是从500元起家的。
I have this bold idea, and eventually I made it come to life. And at the time, my boss told me that I did something nobody ever thought of and nobody could. And I started with only 500 RMB.
后来我开始了我的第二步，开始了我的创业之路。
And the second step was to start my own business.
创业的时候，我有几个梦想。我说也许有一天我也能成为一个行业的小英雄。
At the time, my dream was to become the leader in this field, in my field.
结果经过用了8年的时间，经过大家的支持和帮助下，我所做的领域在中国实现了5个第一。
After 8 years and with the support of my team, I achieved 5 number 1s.
第一个第一就是我所做的过敏源在中国里是填补了中国的空白。那第一个呢，我所做的过敏的领域在中国 FDA 是第一个拿到国家药监局的批号 CFDA。
So the first number one was that the allergen I developed was the first one of its kind to receive CFDA, the Chinese FDA's approval.
第二个第一，在过敏领域我们是第一个获得了国家科技教育部和基金部一等奖。
And this product received the number one prize awarded by Chinese Ministry of Education.
第三个第一，在过敏领域我们是第一个获得了国家科技进步二等奖。
We also received the second prize, the first of its kind, awarded by the Chinese Department of Technology.
第四个第一，国家中国首次启动国家过敏源的标准，12项标准，其中6项是我主持，6项是我参与。
And at the time, the Chinese government started to setting standards to test the allergy symptoms, and I was the person who set up 6 standards out of 12, and for the rest of 6, I was heavily involved.
当我实现，但是在梦想成就小英雄的时候，我想即使成为英雄，英雄很快就会过去的。
At the time, I thought even though I was a leader, but being a hero of the era of being a hero could pass very quickly.
如果我将来能做一个这个 Science Park 这个科技园的话，我想创造一个品牌，可以创造出更多的英雄。
And so I want to start this industrial park where I could attract more heroes and to be successful.
因此从2008年我就开始准备，在2011年的时候我终于实现了第一个生物医药科技园，这个是我正在准备着做的第二个科技园。
So I started the industrial park back in 2008 and by 2011 I officially finished the first biomedical industrial park and I'm working on the second one.
做科技园有3点收获的和体会。
By doing this, setting up this industrial park, I have 3 comments.
跟世界著名的科学家的交流和学习，可以从中得到很多原来所学不到的技术。
First, by working with and collaborating with the faculty members from top universities all over the world, I learned a lot that I could have not gained.
对，也就第一个叫做科技平台。
So this industrial park provides people with a platform for technology.
第二个叫政府资源平台，因为做科技园是有个门槛非常高的，不是所有人都能做，但是又是政府所想要做的。
Second, it's also a platform that has the resources provided by the government, because by setting up this kind of industrial park, there's a high entrance barrier andthe government doesn't easily encourage people to do that.
第三个平台同时还创造了很多投资的机会平台。
It also is a platform to attract investments.
目前我所做的科技园，原来做的是做的科技园，到现在已经有100多家企业了，三分之二是留学生回来创办的。
My industrial park has attracted over 100 startups company, and 2/3 of them were started by people who has overseas background.
这两个等一下我都会用下面的 PPT 的方式，大概简约的十几分钟给大家做一个介绍。
I will later explain in detail the second and third steps.
当我梦想到成为小英雄的时候，同时在创造英雄平台的时候，我又在想如何铸就人才、科技、金融的生态链，是我下一个目标和梦想。
So my next goal is to start this chain where it create intelligent people, technology, and also has a combination of financial services.
如何将政、产、学、研的结合？
I want a combination of government, the production, the research, and the learning.
要做好这个政、产、学、研的结合。
And I want to do a great job out of it.
那必须结合中国的一个政策、环境、法律。
And this has to be done with Chinese policy and under the legal environment.
我曾经讲过，我说在所在国要做的事情，第一个要讲领导喜欢听的话。
I have always been telling people that to start a business, you always have to say something that the government people want to hear.
第二句叫想领导所想不到的事情。
And always think of something that the government officials couldn't think of.
第三句我说出了成绩，政绩归领导，实惠归我们。
And when you have actually achieve something, then the officials can use it as efforts, but then the real beneficial goes to myself.
但是中国又是一个中庸之道的国家，是一个儒学文化很根深蒂固的根深的国家，所以在中国的处事的时候又必须结合中国的儒学文化，所以我说又有三句话。
However, we also need to take in consideration that Chinese has its own unique culture that is heavily influenced by the ancient school of thoughts.
因为中国的很多商人成也在商，败也在商。
A lot of businessmen gain their success by doing business, but they also fall.
中国的四大红顶商人就是一个典型的例子。
And you can know about this by reading the stories of 4 famous businessmen who are also the government officials.
所以我的体会是三句话，是吧？亲近政府。
So, my thoughts are, first of all, we want to get close to the local government.
第二句话是远离政权。
Second, be away from the power.
第三个是用好政策。
Third, make good use of the policies.
这就是我对政产学研结合的自己的理解。
And this is my own understanding of how to make a combination of politics, production, learning, and research.
最后也是对母校的一个想法，假设 NYIT 的一个捐献基金的成立，又会是怎么样呢？
And next is a bold thoughts. What if a donation fund of NYIT is to be established?
好，下面呢，我就刚才说，第一个梦想成就小英雄，就通过我这里所做的成绩的第一个例子，就是成就小英雄的。这个刚才所获得的成绩的一个例子。
Here, we can see the detailed explanation of how to be a small hero in your own field.
刚才我已经介绍了，我们主要是从事这个过敏性疾病的诊断、治疗、预防为一体的公司。
And our company, is focused on the, assessment, the treatment of all allergy-related diseases.
除了我刚才说在中国实现了五个第一之外，目前我们也申请了很多国家的专利，这次还申请了16个国家的专利。
So other than the five number ones I just mentioned, we have also, had a lot of patented products, and we currently have 16, intellectual property patented products.
我们，下面我会选择性的介绍，这是我从2004年开始到现在承担的一些课题。
And here, we can see the project I've been working on since 2004.
承担这么多的课题，我无法一一的介绍，但是我可以用三个特点来概括它。
So I've been working on, so many projects that I won't be able to explain in a short speech, but then, I have some summary for you.
我当时所做的课题几乎同批课题都是排在第一名，或者是获得一等制作、特级一等制作的课题。
So all my projects, has always been ranked as number one for, among all the other projects, submitted to the government, or I have received a first prize or even the highest prize.
第二个特点就是我承担了这些的课题，到现在还有17项是填补了中国的空白。
And the products we have been working on has filled the blank of Chinese history for 17 items.
到现在为止，第三个特点就是有2/3的项目是可以转化为生产力的。
And also 2/3 of my projects can be transferred to actual production.
这是我们发表的部分的文章。
Here you can see these are some of the publications.
今年我又有一篇文章在 Cell Research 的发表，影响因子是14，我是第一作者，希望能投稿成功。这是我们当时发表2011年发表的时候的文章，在当时在中国也是过敏领域属于最高的文章。
This year I will be, working on a paper that is to be published at Cell Research, which has an impact factor of over 14. And in 2011, I successfully published a paper.On clean immuno and with the impact factor of over 11. At the time, it is the highest, the paper, published in the journal that has the highest impact factor.
同时也向大家报，就在我昨天晚上休息之前，我又收到了我的邮件，我们另一篇文章又投稿成功了。
I just received an email last night before I go to sleep, before I went to sleep, that, one of my, papers got successfully accepted.
谢谢谢谢。这是我们国内的一，刚才是国外的文章，这是国内的一部分文章。
So you just saw the papers published in journals overseas, and here are some papers published in China's journals.
这里我想介绍一下，当时做的过敏源的这个产品，全世界做的最好的，世界上瑞典法玛西亚是做的最好的。
Here are some of the products, we have been working on, and at the moment, a company in, Sweden has the best product of its kind.
后来瑞典法玛西亚给法迪亚收购了。
But later, this company was, acquired by, another pharmaceutical company.
后来又给 Sanofi 收购，以32亿欧元的价值给收购掉了。
Later, it was acquired at a price of 3.2 billion euros.
虽然它的技术很领先，我们对它也是一个很大的挑战。 所以目前它中国区的总经理都到我这里来帮助我了。And
even though their project is pioneering in this field, however, our products posed a great challenge and threat to them. That's why their general manager in China has quit his job and came to work for me.
Thank you. 原来我总担心自己的技术不如别人哈。 但是我们经过努力以后，在6月27到30号在弗吉尼亚的学术展会上，我们所做的过敏原的蛋白芯片，不但不在国内落后，在世界上还是处于略微领先一步。I
have been worried that the product we developed might not be the pioneer in the field. However, this year, during June 27 to 30th, at this expo in Virginia, our product not only was well received, but it was also considered the best in the world.
就是这一个技术的改变，这就是加拿大这个UBC大学的教授的合作。当时美国做这个蛋白芯片的技术的时候，花了。 10亿美金最后都失败了，我们花了这个5年的时间，终于完成了我们自己的一个生物芯片的平台。
As you can see, that was a product developed, collaborated with University of British Columbia in Canada. And at that time, somebody else invested $1 billion and failed. However, after 5 years effort, we came up with our own product, and it was a success.
这道机器也是当时在国外进口，要20多万。The
picture you can see here are the devices we imported from overseas, and it cost over 200,000.
特别是这套软件，英国人控制要39万块钱。These
are the softwares which were developed and controlled by people from England, and it cost over
300,000.
So the total comes to over 590,000, and also the foreign experts would control the technology.
哈佛大学一批专家用了1年多努力的时间，花了几百万，把这个蛋白芯片的平台仪器软件和这个试剂联合了，就是说后来我们和哈佛大学、UBC大学、浙江大学，把我们的这个蛋白芯片仪器软件都自己完成了，花了2000万的钱，最后整个技术平台都完成，而且这个技术是我们所自有的。
So then I worked with UBC and Zhejiang University as well as Harvard University. Through years of effort, we successfully developed our own devices as well as the softwares. It did cost around 20 million.
也正是因为我们的这个所做的技术在世界上也是处于领先的。 和最后我们收购了比利时这个Re-Technology 公司的技术。Because
our technology was the it has been the leading forces in the area. We were able to successfully acquire a technology company in Belgium.
这套技术，它的这个所做的技术在世界上也是非常领先的，但是这个技术却被我们收购了。
This is a technology very famous, ranked very high worldwide, but we acquired that technology.
Thank you. 他们不但这个技术非常先进，而且它的仪器、它的软件也是非常先进的。
They not only their technology, but also the devices as well as the software were the leading ones in its kind.
它有500多项的这个技术，都分别获得了这个欧洲的 CE 认证。
They have over 500 technologies that have received certification from from Europe CE.
收割到这个技术的时候，我就想起了这个。原来在这里学习刘院长给他们让我们提高了一个国际视野，记得就是说我们收购比利时的时候，其中当时有个最大的难点就是谈了两天谈不下来，就是因为一个文化差异的问题。
During the process of acquiring this technology, it reminded me of what I have learned here in NYIT under Professor Scott Liu's lessons.That we need to have a broad view internationally. At the time, I was negotiating with this company in Belgium, and we were not able to reach a deal after 2 days of negotiation because there is a wide difference in culture.
问题的焦点，当时他提出的要求要按照欧洲的法律执行，我们提出要按照中国的法律执行。
They want their way under the Europe. Policies and I want the thing to be done in the Chinese way.
后来最后我们提了一个新的思路，说在欧洲执行按照欧洲的法律标准，在中国执行按照中国的法律，在其他国家执行按照属地国家的法律执行。
So we compromised and reached the agreement that while in Europe we'll do it Europe way, while in China we'll do it the Chinese way.In any other places worldwide, we'll do it the way the local culture allows.
最后，而且非常第二个焦点就是我们中国要提出控股51%，他们觉得非常不理解。
And also, they couldn't understand why we want the Chinese side to have 51% of sharehold.
Thank you.这也是我们做的另一个非常前沿的做一个疫苗，这个过敏原螨虫疫苗的 MET
and here you can see this is also an allergen to related to the mites.
目前能做到一公斤级的水平，目前世界上只有丹麦和我们这个科研团队能做到这个水平。
And currently, we have achieved to the level where only us and another company in Europe can achieve.
我下面就一带而过了啊。这是我们所获得一些产品的证书啊。
These are all the certificates for our products.
这也是药监局的这些证书。
Registration certificate。
啊，这是一些项目的立项证书。
And these are certificates where the project gets started。
这是一些项目的验收证书。啊。
And these are certificates to show that the project has been finished.
这是我们申请的一部分专利，这次还有16个国家的专利。
These are all the patents we have received, and we are now waiting for 16 more.
谢谢。Thank you. 这里是我的一部分奖项。
Some of the awards I have received.
这就是我们所获得的这个国家科技进步二等奖，这个是我个人，这个是我单位。
The certificates awarded by the Chinese government, the left side was awarded by me as an individual, and the right side one was awarded to the company.
啊，这是，在2011年九月份的时候，我们在当时经过美国的华人协会推荐所获得的世界百家杰出奖。同时从100名中还选了10名的，所以我是其中一名获得总经理。
As you can see, this is an award I received in 2011, the World Top 100 Outstanding Gold Award. And of this 100, I was one of the 10 selected. The left picture shows an industrial park that I'm working on, and it used to be a building half finished.
后来经过我们的努力以后，现在已经形成了一个生物医药诊断试剂的集聚地和海内外高层次人才的集聚地。
And through the efforts, it has now become a great platform for biomedical information, and also it attracts talents from all over the world. Here are some pictures of the local government officials visiting our company, for example, the mayor of Hangzhou City.
这个要特别介绍一下，这个是卢德和卢纳德这两个专家，这个专家是非常著名的，是欧洲变态就过敏协会的副会长，也是我们这个中方的外籍研究生导师。
The two foreign faces here shown in the right side picture are two experts from Europe, and the gentleman on the left is the mentor for our graduate students.
让我们的技术，让我们的产品走向世界，这两个专家起了很大的作用。
And he's also the leading forces and has a huge impact on having our product to be the pioneering forces in the world.
这个就刚才已经讲过了，这个也介绍，就是正因为我们当时所做的一些科研成的一些突出的贡献，所以08年我也被评为这个科研突出贡献人才，从400多名里面，我是当时被评选了第七名。
Here is some media coverages. Because of my contribution to my field, I was ranked number 7 out of over 400 candidates to be awarded.
Thank you.
It was a great honor, and because of that, the government awarded me with an apartment.
正因为大家的帮助和努力，从创业到现在，我总共所获得的奖励已经达到了800多万，将近900万。Because
of the team efforts, since I started my business, I have been receiving fundings over $8 million.
Thank you. 这个是我在做科技园的时候，又一次给我们做了一个很重要的报道。This
is another media coverage while I was working on the industrial park.
下面我想介绍一下，就是说。 如何搭建这个国际平台，助推行业的发展？也许下面这部分内容对于我们在座的这些那个实际师妹或者说会有一些启发和帮助。
Now I'll be talking about how to establish this international platform and how to promote the development in its own area. And I hope this sharing of my experience will be useful for our students here.
构建第二个科技园，首先建设的目标，我们就是力争成为中国一流的生物医药诊断试剂、医疗器械、医用软件为一体的示范基地。
we want to be a model of a top biomedical assessment and devices as well as software.
构建这样的一个园区的时候，首先要有它园区的特点，第二个需要结合整个市场和行情所需求，所做的科技园才有生命力和竞争力。
I think that only an industrial park that takes into consideration of the needs from market will be sustaining.
我们重点主要有几个，第一个呢就是开展的科技服务、药证服务、金融服务。
We provide services in technology, with the medical certification as well as financial services.
第二个内容就是创建研发平台、生产平台。
We also strive to establish a platform that focuses on research and development as well as production and sales.
第三个功能是促进中欧成果转化，中欧的技术成果转化。
We also want to make sure all these researches would actually convert into production.
第三是建立中国与比利时、法国、欧洲的一些友好合作城市。
We also hope that we can establish friendshipness between Belgium and France and China.
中国正在提倡的科技兴国、科技兴市的，但是如果要科技兴国、科技兴市，它必然需要有高端的服务。
Currently, the Chinese government is promoting by using the technology to make the country stronger. By doing that, we need great talents, great minds.
这个服务不是像过去所说的第三产业简单的服务，它需要像纽约这样的一个城市一样世界的金融服务，就像需要像欧洲一样它这样的科技的服务。
We also need to provide high-end services. For example, the financial services that you can see here in New York, Manhattan, Worldwide Financial Center. Also, in the technology aspect, services that you can find in Europe.
所以三年前，我们当时杭州市长开会的时候，我也是当时的其中一个智囊之一。我们去开会的时候就提倡了，既然要科技兴市，就必须需要有真正的高端服务。这个高端服务就是指的是这个，刚才这一些内容也是其中之一。
So 3 years ago, when the mayor of Hangzhou City asked for a meeting, which I was one of the members for his think tank, we also discussed here that we need to provide high-end services.
特别是引进技术的时候，又跟国外建立了友好合作城市，政府也是非常支持的。
The government is very supportive that during the process of introducing advanced knowledges from overseas, that the friendship has also been established.
好，刚才我这里呢，就是介绍一下。在美国的生物医药产值和医疗器械的比例是1:1，欧洲大概是1:0.7。
As you can see here, the production power of medical and devices in U.S. is 1:1, while in Europe is 1:0.7.
根据 Corolla Information 的统计，在2014年时候，全球医疗的市场将有3610亿美元。
And according to this Colorama information, in 2014, the market for medical devices globally would be around $360 billion.
根据 InvaluMedTech 统计，它2020年的时候，全球的市场将达到5140亿美元。
And according to InvaluMedTech, by 2020.That market will grow to $514 billion.
这个行业增长的最快的就是生物医药的诊断试剂。
And in this market, the fastest growing part would be the biomedical access devices.
因此，如果能搭建这样的一个平台，又是一个非常好的资源整合。
So by providing this platform, it would gather all the resources.
这就是我们通过这个最后也是能形成一个海内外高层次的人才集聚、生物医药诊断、医疗器械软件的集聚地。
So we are hoping that this would be a place where high-end talents home and abroad would be attracted. And it will also be a place where the assessment, where the medical devices and software will be produced.
This整个的运作的机制就是用技术、人才、资本这有机的结合。
The mechanism of running this platform will be a combination of technology, talents, and resources.
这就结合了，做的这个科技园就是用了，我们的智慧、政府的资源、民间的资本。
So, there are three.Components of this industrial park. The first is the know-how. The second is the resources provided by local government. And third is the investment by venture capitals.
所以我所做的两个科技园，第一个科技园，投资了5.6亿，实际上我们一分钱都没出，用的就是我们的智慧。第二个科技园3亿多的时候，同样是一样，我们一分钱没出，也是用了我们的智慧。
So the first industrial park we already established, it cost $560 million, and we didn't invest a penny of actual money. We used our know-how and knowledge. The second industrial park that we're working on now, it has already cost over $300 million, and we didn't invest a penny again. It's all our wisdom.
Thank you.为什么我们的科技园做得比别人与众不同，就是有生命力，其中最重要的就是我们的药证服务。
The difference between my industrial park and others is the services provided for the medical certification.
如何让科学家安心做好科研，关键要做好三个高端服务。
How to make sure the scientists would focus only on working on its products. There are three things we should provide them.
比如如何帮他做标准。
First, how to set up standards for them.
如何做 GMP 厂房的设计。
How to plan the labs for them.
如何做临床。
How to work on the clinics.
如何报批，最后获得 CFDA 的批号
？How to submit approval and eventually receive the approval？
对于很多科学家，这些都不是他的强项。
For a lot of scientists, it's not in their expertise.
如果我们能把它做好这些工作，不但节约了他的时间成本、人力成本。
By providing that service, we're saving these scientists the time as well as the labor.
而且提高了他的工作效率和他的这个成果转化率。
We also would improve the efficiency as well as the percentage of this conversion rate.
如果我们能做到这些工作的话，那这个投资来说，可能我就不要出钱，人家都愿意跟我们无形资产过了，技术过了。
So by providing the services, the companies would actually.Be willing to provide us with shares because we're providing this know-how.
所以我在很多欧洲和美国引进的技术，他们就怕我不投资。其实我不要出钱，只要我愿意帮助他们服务，他或多或少都可以给我股份。
A lot of the technologies I work to introduce to China, they are afraid that I won't invest them, and I'm not actually investing the money. They want my knowledges and help them to get all the approvals.
所以我想借此说，在座的各位同学，如果你们的管理上也能做到了非常的精致啊， 你们又能结合金融的机会，这个杠杆结合，也许你们将来会用同样的原理比我做得更好啊，甚至要用你们的智慧，同样可以得到更多的这种投资的机会和无形资产。
So my comments to my fellow students here is that, by using your wisdom, especially with a combination of the financial mind, you might be able to achieve more than what I can do.
创造这样的平台，就是让他们只要有想法，就可以通过园区的公共实验室，把想法变成新的技术或产品。实验室向入驻的科技人员、研究型的企业提供免费或者部分收费开放。
As long as you have an idea, you can,
创造这个平台目的就是只要有想法的人都可以实现他的梦想。
So the platform I provide to the new entrepreneurs is that as long as they have an idea, it is very possible to realize that through my platform.
当然所做的这些东西除了为创业者提供也是需要有社会效益，更重要的是为政府能解决什么问题，这就是我们所做的这个社会效益的分析。
We also want to contribute to the local government, see what we can bring them with.
政府既需要社会效益也需要经济效益。
The government is not only looking for the economic benefits but also the social benefits.
这就是我们的这个团队，这是我们欧洲的这个外方的总经理，这 Nolly 博士是原来法国第十一大学的教授，他后来又创办了公司，现在又是这个北部的这个评审专家。
And this is an MD from Europe. He used to be a professor in France and later started his own company. Now he is the general manager for my industrial park as a foreign representative.
这些也是我们外方的专家啊，阿兰博士。
These are all, great minds from overseas that, part of our team.
这个是我们中方的这团队。
The Chinese team.
嗯，这是袁立刚一开大学回去的一个专家。
He graduated from University of Oregon.
这是原来加州大学回去的一个专家。
And he quit his job in University of California and returned to China.
这是我本人。
And that's me.
我除了刚才这些，我现在呢也是多个政府的顾问。
And I'm also a consultant to a lot of government projects.
啊，所以我刚才说，只要创建好这样的一个平台，就会带来很多的机会啊！只要有梦想的人都在可以实现啊。然后，像，比如这里就有非常多的这些项目，我借此机会呢，会借。因为这么多项目，我无法一一的介绍，我只能简单的介绍一个项目。
So, like I just mentioned, by providing this platform, the opportunities present themselves. And here are quite a few projects I've been working on. Because of the time limit, I will be only focusing on one of them.
这家公司的 technology 公司的技术已经被我们收购了。这家公司的技术我们现在谈得非常好，十月份又准备过去签约了。
So the first Belgium Zentech, we already acquired their technology. The second one we're working on and will be signing an agreement in October.
下面几个我将介绍一下智慧医疗的东西。这是法国的一家公司，做一个智能的筷子。
Number four, this is a technology from France and they are working on an intelligent chopstick.
同时是一个智能的奶瓶。
It also works as an intelligent sip cup.
比如小孩子在幼儿园里喝这个奶的时候，他被怕呛住了，但是呢，妈妈的手机里依然可以看到小孩子这个喝奶的速度快慢，是否有被呛住，是否保姆或者说是老师对他照顾的不周。
So for example, if the baby is drinking milk from this bottle, the moms can actually watch from her apps on her cell phone that if the baby is drinking at a consistent rate.If the nanny or the people who providing the care is doing a great job.
这样技术的产品在在中国深圳生产现在供不应求，在美国来生产都来不及。
This product is being manufactured in Shenzhen, China, and the need is way over the production rate.
我下面介绍一下这样子。这是一个，也是一个智慧医疗的项目啊。它有三个摄像头，一个是叫三维摄像头，三级摄像头，第二个是红外线摄像头，第三个是普通的摄像头。
This is also a device that has intelligent in it. It has three cameras. The first one is a 3D camera. The second is an ultra red camera. And third is a regular camera.
由于这个也是一个非常好的一个项目，但是呢，也是带来了很多的这个机会，因为时间的情况，我想呢，我就肯不能把它一一的展开了。
This is a great device, and it brings a lot of opportunities.
最后一个想法就是说，如果将来有机会的时候，我们也可以借鉴于这些耶鲁、哈佛、斯坦福大学著名的学校，筹建一个校友捐献基金。
So my thought is to take example as.Has been done at Yale University, Harvard University, and Stanford University, establish a fund, a donation fund, as well as an investment fund by the alumni.
其中做的最成功的是耶鲁大学。
Yale University is the among the best.
同时还想就是说，如果将来有可能设立一个 VC 基金和 PE 基金。
Hopefully, we can also establish a venture capital fund as well as a PE fund.
这样的想法就是让我们杰出的校友带带头为学校捐助一些基金。
So hopefully those outstanding alumni will voluntarily donate to NYIT.
三个基金。第二个，如果有一些，比如说来学习的这些学生，可能家里也有很多的闲置的资金，如果看到了非常好的项目。如果做长线的投资，就可以做 VC 的基金来投资；如果是短期需要回报的，就可以做 PE 的基金投资。
So for those students who have some money that they want to make use of, to seek long-term benefits, they can invest in this VC fund. And for those who seek short-term return, they can invest in this PE fund.
假设这个能成功，那么将来我们也可以。有所借鉴，比如说捐献基金50%捐献产生的效益捐给母校，50%给捐献的人或者投资人。
So if this fund has returns, maybe 50% can goes back to the school and 50% will be given back to the donor or the investors.
这样，三个月。这样做呢，使学生可以和学校形成更好的互动效应。
So by doing so, the students as well and the school can have a better interaction and has this relationship going on.
这是一个大胆的想法，但是也许不成熟。
This is a bold but maybe immature idea.
我的演讲完了，谢谢大家。
Professor Wu has given us a speech, talk about his history, his past, and what he has accomplished. This has actually set a model, role model for us. I hope among the audience, the students here, we will have a lot more such like him. Most importantly, he is not only talking about his self-accomplishment, but also talking about giving back to support the school. So that is really appreciated. And because we are limited in time, so we will have some other plan and the reservation, etc. So we have to stop here. I'm sure we will still have a lot more opportunities to communicate, to learn from Mr. Wu. And next, there's, we also to, in order to show our appreciation to Professor Wu. By the way, I forgot to mention that Professor Wu fly all the way here just to deliver this lecture, and he leave tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, and he paid for his own airfare. And also, I made a hotel reservation for him. I thought that NYT should pay for his hotel, but he told me I've returned money that back. I told the hotel, don't charge NYT. So he insists on paying for his own hotel. And to show appreciations, we have want to give Mr. Professor Wu some recognition. And Vicky, would you please?
It's my greatest pleasure to provide this special recognition award to the most wonderful professor, Professor Wu Shandong. I have to say that I have learned so much about his company, individual. He's really, truly very, very touched of everything he accomplished. And I'm really very grateful and such a great honor to know you. Thank you, Professor Wu.
Now, last, I want to say we can have achieved such a successful event because of many, many people has been involved. We have a lot of volunteers, and we have many of the students from the previous cohorts has come and decided to support as a result. So we can have such, when you new school come here, you face a lot of obstacles. But with all of them, life would be a lot more difficult. So let's have applause for all those who have supported our program, has volunteered their time and energy to support you. Thank you very much. Let's give them a applause.
I want to take this opportunity to thank Professor Scott Liu, who's really the bridge between United States and China, without whom we would never have any program from China at NYT. So thank you so much for Professor Wu, and we all Scott Liu, and also want to say thanks. Where's Jenny? Jane, who's another person who brought so many wonderful things at NYT, always so supportive of NYT. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Vicky.